You're beautiful. I'm beautiful. Let's be beautiful together.
Hey, my name's Drew.
Hi. So when you order a drink at Starbucks, do you order a hot tea or is it considered cannibalism? Get it?
Hi, I'm Colin. I have a Jeep. You have a Jeep. We're made for each other. Let's go.
What I look for in a partner, someone like you.
What? What?
Back off. This is my minute and 54 seconds.
I'm sorry, but you are just so beautiful.
Goodbye, Mark.
So you like Jack?
You're beautiful, by the way.
I throw Jav, and I'm the basketball manager. I write down the stats, you know, keep the score. Threes, twos, foul shots. That's just how it is.
Hey, are you a campfire? Because you're hot, and I want some more.
Welcome to the February edition of Husky TV,
your news source for what's happening at MRHS.
My name is Mark Ariglia.
And I'm Miranda Allen.
Husky TV starts now. The songs on the radio are okay, but my taste in music is your face. And it takes a song to come around.
Story that's very newsworthy. Okay, that was not a good one. Here's my news story on Husky View. Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. I was just reading the latest issue of Husky View. You know, if you like the Husky TV news show, you'll love Husky View. They have similar stories to us, and their content's pretty good too. Today, we're gonna go check out Husky View. We'll be interviewing the faculty advisor, the editors, and a couple members. Come on, let's go.
So basically we just start with a huge brainstorming thing on the board where everyone in the class picks three things that they really want to write about, and then depending on whether if we decide that is tired news, old news, or like not really interesting or relevant to our audience, that's how we choose. And then when they write the article, it goes through the whole editing process and then it gets put in the paper.
We usually publish things that are currently going on in the school, so anything with sports, activities, anything that's going on, we usually make sure we put in the issue for the paper. So we have a fall issue, a winter issue, a spring, and a summer issue. And in those issues, we highlight the sports in each season and any other activities or highlights going on in the school.
We do a lot of different content based on the editions. We'll do school news, we'll do an important story, we have community news, we have world news, and we have everything from celebrity gossip to what is happening around town.
I love being a part of the Husky View Club because it gives me an opportunity to write outside of school and talk about topics that are around the school and around the community that I don't normally get to talk about in my English class.
You can check out Husky View basically anywhere. And their new issue is coming out pretty soon. For Husky TV, this is Miranda Allen, and as always, stay classy, Madawan.
Now it's time for our man on the street, Mark Goriglia. Oh wait, that's Mark Guariglia. That's my last name.
Come on, everybody, up on your feet. Let's do the mouse dance.
Hi, Mark Ariglia here, and welcome to another episode of Mark on the Street. Today we're walking around asking a very interesting question. Is a hot dog a sandwich? Is a hot dog a sandwich?
No.
Explain your reason.
Because I think a hot dog is a hot dog and a sandwich is a sandwich. Like, I don't know. What do you want me to say?
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
100%. 100%. The definition of a sandwich is a piece of meat, etc., in between two slices of bread.
It says right here, Merriam-Webster, also known as the dictionary. You know, it's the dictionary. It settles the debate and calls a hot dog a sandwich. So whatever the dictionary says, I agree with. Now,
not at all.
But the dictionary, like I said right here.
Hot dog is not a sandwich according to the official press release from the National Hot Dog and Sausage.
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
No.
No.
Yes.
It is a sandwich. A sandwich is bread covering something.
No. Because it's in between a bun and there's nothing else on it.
Sandwich? I don't like hot dogs.
It's not the question.
I don't like sandwiches or hot dogs, honestly.
Hot dog a sandwich?
Yes.
Explain your reasoning.
I love hot dogs.
Bread. I've heard people try and reason this with like, oh, yeah, but people would be like, oh, if a hot dog is a sandwich, then a cereal is a soup. But that's not true.
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
Oh my god, why? Yes. No, it's not. No, it's definitely not a sandwich. Because it's just not.
Yes.
A hot dog is a sandwich because it's in between two pieces of bread. Although the pieces of bread are, to make this argument right, a sub is a sandwich.
What? On Google, it says it's not considered a sandwich.
But the dictionary says it is a sandwich.
Well, sometimes the dictionary's wrong.
At least it's not 2016. We sat down with some of our own to try and predict what this year has in store for us.
Didn't see you there.
Okay. Which block makes me feel peaceful? Alright. What will happen to you in 2017? Oh, new year, new me.
New year, new me.
Look at this dude.
Which block makes you feel peaceful?
I'm gonna go with the pink ones. I love pink.
Which green is the prettiest?
I really hate green. Green reminds me of the Jets. Let's see.
Which block makes you uncomfortable?
I really don't like the color orange. I thought I was wearing an orange shirt for a second.
Which block is the most exciting?
This one has the most colors.
Which pink is hideous to you?
This grayish one, because it's stupid.
2017, you'll get a new job.
Go through a breakup.
I'll get in a relationship.
You'll go through a breakup.
Oh my god!
Students that succeed in the class and in the community are recognized for their merits in the NHS. We sat down with the advisors and student leaders to learn more about this student organization.
In the National Honor Society, there are four pillars: scholarship, leadership, character, and service. And the first requirement is scholarship. Students have to have a 3.7 GPA average, cumulative. And these are juniors or seniors. That makes you eligible, and then you would get a candidate packet. And in that packet, students would show evidence of continued service to the school and the community. They would show evidence of leadership and, of course, attributes of character.
At our meetings, usually the officers will facilitate and try to get ideas from the students. And then at the beginning of the year, we actually did a fundraiser where students brought in all kinds of school supplies, books, notebooks, rulers, you know, drawing supplies, pens, pencils. And we sent them over to Louisiana for the victims of the flood down there.
Well, because it's student-led, the students definitely feel like they're making a bigger impact on the community. But basically, it's one of those things where it's like, it may not seem like you're doing a lot, but when you realize that the number of people who need help continues to grow, that like the small impact that we do make definitely does make a difference, especially in our local community.
Welcome to History with Mara Alexander Hamilton. I'm Mara Alexander Hamilton, and today we're going to talk about a Mattawan alumni, J. Michael Straczynski. Joseph Michael Straczynski was born July 17, 1954 in Patterson. He is an American screenwriter, television producer, director, and comic book writer. Straczynski has created shows such as Babylon 5 and Sense8. He has written for many Hollywood movies such as Thor and World War Z, and has written many, and I mean many, comic books, Marvel, Icon, DC, you name it. J. Michael Straczynski is no stranger to accolades. He's won Hugos, BAFTAs, GLAAD Media Awards, and Saturns. He is an inspiration to future creators out there, including including myself. You can follow him at Twitter. His handle is @Strasinski. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Hi, I'm Colin Hayward. Now get ready, Madawan, because the McHugh Factor begins now.
So, today on the McHugh Factor, we have... It's not the McHugh Factor? Oh, alright. Today, this is Jeopardy! So, today on Jeopardy, we have four categories. We have school, sports, movies, and a rant. So on the left, we have contestant number one, drug. In the middle, we have contestant number two, Freddy. And on the right, we have contestant number three, Luigi. I hope you all have a great game, good luck, and may the best man win. Okay, so today, let's start with Luigi. Let me get school for 100. So, school for 100, MRHS is in this town.
What is Manawan?
What is Aberdeen?
That's correct. Now it's your turn to pick a category.
I'll take movies for 300.
So movies for 300. This many actors played Spider-Man in a live action movie.
What is four?
What is three?
I'll take random for 100.
This famous movie was worked on by Craig Berfine, starring Bruce Willis.
What is Try Hard Dope?
Wait, who are you? Why are you even on my set? I'm you, bro. Bro, I'm me. Bro, I am you.
At every sports games, you can find them cheering on our Huskies. Here's an exclusive look at the Dog Pound and our school's basketball team.
My role is really like, what I do is I start most of the chants, and like I usually stand in the back with all the underclassmen.
Just making sure that everyone's like always into the game, and like making sure we're supporting our teams and just getting loud and getting everyone into the game.
Make sure we get as loud as possible for our players and our school.
Being in the Dog Pound is pretty cool, it's fun, it's a good experience, and I hope I can continue to be in it throughout the years.
Honestly, it is the greatest experience ever, and I'm gonna miss it when I go to college.
In the morning and to be well, quite honest with you, I ain't really sleep well. You ever feel like your train of thought's been derailed? That's when you press on, lean in. Half the population just waiting to see me fail. Yeah, right, you better off trying to freeze hell. Some of us do it for the females, and others do it for the retail. What I do it for the kids, life through the towel in on. Every time you fall, it's only making your chin strong. And I'll be in your corner like Mick, baby, till the end of when you hear me strong from that big lady. Until the referee rings the bell, until both your eyes start to swell, until the crowd goes home, what we gonna do, y'all? Give them hell, turn the hands, gonna live life till we're dead. Give me scars, give me pain, then they say of me, say of me, say of me. There goes the fighter.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you guys next time.
Stay classy, Madawan.
And now we bring you Husky News' embarrassment, Crazy Sal!
You don't think I'll do it? I'll do it. You think I'm gonna show an R-rated movie on PG-13 network? I wanna do it!
Mom Spaghetti!
Merry Christmas! Happy Hanukkah! Happy Quads! I can't get this! Happy Hanukkah Quads, miss! It's your boy Sal! Happy Hanukkah Quads, miss! It's your boy Sal! And take a fight! Oh, I don't think so!
For 19 years, wanna fight me, fight me.
What? It's the Nutshack. Well, anyway, in today's news, we're gonna cover the election, and
after this,
your health. Mom Spaghetti.